Welcome to Cybertech. In today's video, we'll be fixing common Gophish problems. Common Gophish errors are like Gophish problems, sending emails, tracking clicks, and making sure your phishing simulation runs smoothly. So let's dive in. So a lot of users face problems like Gmail blocking accounts, test email showing up blank, and landing pages not opening, and tracking not working. Don't worry, I'll show you the step-by-step method of how to fix it. So the first one is Gmail blocking sending profile. So this is sending profile. So why would Gmail want to block your sending profile? There is a lot of reasons for that. Okay, the first issue is when you have a new Gmail account, when your Gmail is just newly created, so it tends to raise suspicion to the Gmail. Okay, that's the first issue. So to avoid this, you need to create your account in advance and warm it up. All right, then use proper SMTP settings. That's the most important one. So before you get, make sure you don't use the Gmail, your regular Gmail password. Stay tuned. I will tell you how to generate the password you need in Gmail later in the video. All right. Or better still, you can use SendGrid or built-in SMTP servers, which are reliable. Or better still, you can build your own SMTP, just like in the video above. I made this thing, showed you how to build your own SMTP service and send unlimited emails without restrictions legally. Okay, so the next thing on our list is the blank email issues. A lot of people complain about blank email templates. All right, so this is template. All right, let me go to new template. So the blank email template here, a lot of things can cause it, right? Which is the Gmail incorporates a lot of security, and so whenever most of this security do not allow you to copy the whole code needed for it to function very well. Okay, so what some people do is they go to copy old versions of like Gmail before the security, recent security features are included. All right, so you also need to when your template is not showing, you also need to add subject and body of your message so it doesn't look like it's a spam message, because Gmail don't like messages that looks like spam. All right, so another thing is people complain about maximum connection attempts. So let's get to that point. So it's going to be from your sending profile. So let's go to this thing. So if you're facing issues like your email is not sending, and you are having when you try to send like a test email, it's going to show you the error message of maximum connection attempts exceeded. So here is what to do. This is an example. Okay, profile name, let's say tests. So first name, I already made this thing in my video. All right, so this is from where the SMTP is going to come from. So let's say this email, I just put the email. So this is from where the SMTP, the email is going to be from the sender. All right, so I just put like this. Let me do like this. So here in the host, you need to copy the correct Gmail host if you're not using your own SMTP server. Because when I made a video about where I showed you how to build your own SMTP server, I showed you the server host you're going to use. All right, so here, if you look very well, you're going to see smtp.example.com, then colon, then the port. You need to include it. So when you make a mistake, it's not going to go. So let's go. This is the Gmail server, smtp.gmail.com. So we copy it. We go here. We paste it. Then you need to put the colon. Then you need to add the port. So what port are we going to use? 587 is with TLS, which is more secured. 465 is SSL. So we'll just use 587. So I just put 587. So the username is, if you're using a Gmail SMTP, it's going to be your Gmail. All right, so let's say this is the Gmail SMTP I'm using. That's going to be my username. So here in the password, you need the app password, not the password you use to log into your account. It's not going to work. So if you're using the password you use to log into that same account, it's not going to work. So you need to generate an app password. To generate an app password, just go here in your account, you click here, you go to manage Google accounts. So you need to make sure you already set two-factor authentication on, and they are going to ask you to verify your mobile number and also I think your email or something. So when you're here, you're going to go to security. When you are in security, just type app password. As you can see, it already brought it out here. So it's going to ask you to log in again. So you just put your password. The password you're going to put is the one for your Gmail account now, because it's trying to verify since you're generating an app password. So when it's open, it's going to ask you the name of the app password, like what's this thing. So, but it's good for you to name it the particular something you're going to do. So mine is like Gophish. I'll just put GOP as my app name. So I'm going to create. So here is the password. It's created. This is the password I need to do what I want to do. So let's go back to the sending profile. So here I'll just paste my password. All right, so I'll leave this the way it is. What else needs to be done? So I'll try to save. Let me save. So let's go back there. Once we already save, let's try to send a test email. So maybe ABC DCG. So to the email I want to send it to, so you can just use any email. I can use my own email to do it. So I can use my own email to try it. So I'll just put my email here and I'll just try to send, and let's see if it's going to work. So as you can see, email sent. So let's go to the email and see. You can see now it worked. So if you follow the instructions the way I'm doing it, it's going to work. I've shown it again to you. You can see it's working. So the next thing we are going to go to is the issue most people complain again. It's about when they try to send their emails. When the test emails, this thing is going to rotate, and at the end of the day, it's going to tell them connection timeout, maximum, whatever. Any error you see, it shows there are things you need to do to fix this. All right, just like you see, the email we sent went through. So to fix that, just make sure you put the correct this thing, SMTP server colon and the port. It's very important. You need to do it. You need to put the correct username, which is the email. If you're using Gmail SMTP, if you're using your own personal SMTP, it's your own personal email that is going to be here. If it's your own personal SMTP, you don't need an app password. Your normal password can do it. So I'll link the video below where I created an SMTP. You can watch it and create your own and try the simulation out on your own. Most people say the email they sent, it's not going through. When you click the link, it's not going to this thing, your landing page like that. So to do this thing, let's go to campaign. For example, I'll go to new campaign. This is where your error comes from, here in the URL here. That error, to fix it, make sure what it's here is correct. So for example, I'm doing this in my local environment, so my URL should be this, like this. I'll just copy it. So my URL is this. I'll remove the S. So this is my URL since I'm doing it. No, you're going to remove the ports. So this is my URL since I'm doing it in my local environment. So, but if you're doing it in a VPS server, it's going to be either HTTP or HTTPS slash your VPS IP number, IPv4 number, or it's going to be your domain here. So just get the URL correct. So if you're using a Gmail to test it out, this is what it's, and you're doing it in a local host, this is what it's going to look like. All right. Other people complained about the landing page not working. So let's go to landing page. New landing page. Here in the landing page, what I feel is most times some of these big companies, they upgrade their security in such a way, when you copy the email or the HTML code, some are omitted. It's a security feature. People, companies like Google has that. Okay, so if you're just a security professional who's trying to test this on their own, you can just draft a simple HTML, or you look for old HTML where you can use to test it out. So, but if you get the correct HTML code, or you can just do import, for example, just put the URL of the landing page you want to get. All right, you can just put the URL and it's going to get it. But if you do this to something like Google, you're not going to get it correctly because of the security features I just mentioned now. So some people said they face issues also tracking their emails. So in your template, to fix that tracking of email, say you need to make sure you this add tracking image, it's ticked. All right, don't untick it. If you untick it, it's going to be difficult for your this thing to track. So this is what tracks, because when you send an email, it's automatically in Gophish automatically includes like an image where when the email is open, it's going to send you a signal like, okay, this person already opened this email. So when this part is not ticked, it's not going to track what you really want it to do. I'll be ending this video here. I don't want to make it so long. If this video helped you, make sure to like, subscribe, and leave a comment. If you need help with your simulation lab, you just contact me, or just in the comment section drop a comment and I will respond to it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.